our offering this morning is for Crosstown Impact. That is the ministry that, yes, thank you, Greg Holcroft, is heads up. And it's usually that they have ministry in the schools in our area, and also after school programs and so on and so forth. And they are still able to do that to some degree, but they are also being innovative and creative in their work. And so, yeah, David. Oh, they were up until this week able to do ministry in the schools to some degree, but that's being shut down. So please pray for them. They need your support, not only in terms of prayers, but also, of course, financially. This is a tough time for all kinds of ministries. Also, we are not having a Thanksgiving Day service tomorrow, and so we encourage you to spend that time with family, doing devotions together, and celebrating God's goodness, and being grateful to Him together as a family. But we do have an offering for tomorrow, which may seem weird, but it's not, because we're all fancy digital and electronic-y, and so you can give even if we don't have a service. So our offering tomorrow is for World Renew, and we would encourage you to think about that too, because their work is incredibly important as they serve many peoples throughout this world during this very difficult time. Also, in terms, before we get to congregational prayer, I wanted to update you on the Weavers. We support the Weavers as they work with Wycliffe, and they are trying to get back to Papua New Guinea. They had to have negative COVID tests for all five of them within the right time frame for them to be able to go. And it was a little bit touch and go as to whether that would work out. They ended up at one point with four of the tests had come back, but then there was some technical problem with the fifth test, and that was thankfully fixed. And so now they are currently, as far as we know, in Qatar and on their way to Papua New Guinea. So please pray for Nate and Jesse and their family as they continue that journey. Now there's a little poem / prayer that I wanted to read for you just before we started our congregational prayer time as well. And so this is a traditional little prayer, and it reminds us so much of the simple things that we can be thankful for. And it goes like this: for mother love and father care, for brothers strong and sisters fair, for love at home and here each day, for guidance lest we go astray, Father in heaven, we thank thee. For this new morning with its light, for the rest and shelter of the night, for health and food, for love and friends, for everything His goodness sends, Father in heaven, we thank thee. And on that note, I wanted to ask you, what are you grateful for this morning that you would like to praise the Lord our God together for? Yeah, Jeanette. A loving, supportive congregation. Wonderful. Thank you, Jeanette. We are so glad that we can be that for you. And hopefully for everybody else, too. Yes, I saw a couple other hands. Yeah, John? For God's faithfulness, not mine. Yeah, God is indeed faithful, even when we are not. Willie? thought I saw a hand somewhere else. Yeah, Aki. Amen. Yeah, Jared. Amen. Good. Yeah. Good. Amen. Gratitude for a good harvest in the end, and for all that that provides in so many different ways. Yeah, amen, amen. David. The blessing of family, amen. Even if we cannot be all together as families, nonetheless, it is so good have those families. Yeah. Okay. Isn't that the most fundamental thing? That gratitude for our salvation, that relationship between us and God can be fixed, and we can be adopted, and oh yeah. Amen. 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 Nick says the love between a man and a woman. I suspect that he maybe means even him and Jackie. No. Maybe we have to have another visit. Amen. Good. Sorry. Oh, Clarence. Yeah. Yeah, how creative our God is in the changing of the seasons. What a beautiful fall this has been in so many ways. Wonderful. Thank you, God. Let us come to the Lord our God in congregational prayer. Father in heaven, we thank you. We have so much to be thankful for. Father, we thank you for Crosstown Impact and the ministry that the Whole Cross have there. Lord, we know that they're facing tough times with COVID and how that interferes with ministry opportunities. But we thank you so much for how creative they have been able to be so far. And we pray that you will enable them to get back into those schools soon so that they can continue to minister there. We thank you also for the ongoing work of World Renew throughout this entire planet and how they are working to help out various people in various situations throughout the world. Closer to home, oh God, we thank you for anniversaries and for the love between a man and a woman. Particularly, oh God, we thank you right now for Willie and Herman and their anniversary. We thank you, oh God, that they were able to celebrate together with folks and how that was possible even in this situation, and how supportive and loving the community is, and how your goodness shines through. Lord, we thank you also for Nate and Jessica Weaver and their family and the mission that you have called them to, and that they are heading back out to Papua New Guinea. Lord, we pray that you will be with them on the rest of their journey. Thank you so much for your intervention in making sure that those tests were done in proper and good order, even in spite of difficulties. We thank you so very much for our health care system. We thank you for Alan and for his good spirits and for how you are caring for him at Brockville General. But we also thank you for our dedicated health care workers on all different fronts, who are seeking to care as well as they possibly can for everybody who comes into their sphere. Lord, we pray. We pray as well that you will be with our healthcare system as it is under increasing strain. And we pray, O God, that you will be with all of our structures and systems in this country and in this world. We know that no human institution is perfect. And so we pray that you will constantly draw us all closer to you, that we may do your will in every way, every day. Lord, we pray and we thank you for our loving congregation here, our supportive congregation here. We too are nowhere near perfect, but we thank you that Jeanette and others can experience the love and support of a community of believers. Father, we thank you so much for your faithfulness to us. In spite of often our own faithlessness, God, if you could not be relied upon, then where would we be? We are so grateful for that. Father, we are grateful for the changing of seasons, O God, for the beauty that surrounds us. If you could be hit in the face in a positive way, the beauty around us would be like that. It is so obvious and so clear that you are creative and full of life and love and joy and beauty. Your mercy and love overflow to us. Not only, O God, is it beautiful around us, but also we thank you so much for the harvest that is coming in. We thank you that in spite of our worries, in spite of our anxieties, you bring in a beautiful crop. And that once again, you sustain the people of this area and this country and this world. Lord, wherever we as broken human beings have messed up or not improved the systems so that people can indeed reliably receive food in this world, we pray again for your forgiveness, and we ask that you would help us to continue to feed the people of this world. And Lord, in the meantime, may we continue to work and live each and every day seeking to follow your footsteps. Father, we thank you so much, most of all, for your Son, Jesus Christ, and for our salvation given through him. Father, we know that without Jesus, his love, his life, his death, his resurrection, his sacrifice for us, his conquering of sin and death, without that, O God, we would be truly hopeless. And so, Lord, we praise you for that. We praise you, O God, for the love between a man and a woman. We praise you for that. Oh God, please guide us and keep us as families and friends. Lord, we praise you for the blessings of families. And we ask that as we come to your scripture and look more thoroughly at it, that you would open our hearts to hear what you would have us hear. In Jesus' name we pray.